Okay, so just to review, so this was our original plan in the original application. So we are going to go for the 2x2 factorial design. The reason was just, it was just for efficiency. So using 2x2 design, you can actually test the effect of two different interventions using just a sample size for just one trial. Only if you can assume no interaction effect between the two treatments. So we assumed no interaction, and that was our design. And we were going to use piecewise logistic regression to compare the primary outcome. Because as Kevin already said, because of all the things going on about, you know, opioid epidemic, you know, all the public pressure and other interventions going on, we thought the rate, the opioid prescription rate, will go down anyways. And what we wanted to detect was that our interventions will accelerate that. So we wanted to compare the slope of the two, you know, the two groups, between the two groups. And to do that, rather than using regular chi-square test or regular logistic regression, we wanted to use piecewise logistic regression that has time as a covariate. But for sample size calculation, there is no like a closed form formula to calculate the power to detect this slope difference in piecewise logistic regression, because it's quite complicated model. There is no like software packages that calculates that power for you. So we just use chi-square test just for the sample size calculation part. And then the external statistical reviewers concerned was really, mainly was 2 points. So the first was, why do you use 2x2 factorial design? You said you don't assume interaction. And if you are not interested in interaction, you don't need to test the interaction. Then why do you just go for the three-arm design? So basically, the reviewer said, instead of doing this, just divide randomize the clinics into three arms. Because it's simpler that way. So in our response back to them, we said 2x2 design is sometimes used to test the interaction, but more than half of the time, it is actually for efficiency. So more specifically, if we can assume no interaction between the two interventions, to test the effect of opioid justification, we can just compare these two pink boxes versus two blue boxes to estimate the effect of the opioid justification. Whereas you with three-arm design, you just have to discard the third of the data and use just two-thirds of the data. So this way, we lose some power. It's same for the other intervention, right? So we explained all this in the response. And their second criticism was that, well, your no interaction assumption is not really justified, which is kind of true. We really don't know if there will be an interaction or not. Also, she said, if there is an interaction, then your 2x2 design might be underpowered, which is also a valid point. Another concern the reviewer had was, your proposed analysis plan is piecewise logistic regression, and then you calculated power based on chi-square test. So these two don't agree each other. So we said, it is pretty common, you know, in grant application, you just detail all this nice sophisticated analysis plan, and then usually for power analysis you use much simpler model. And actually, because our piecewise logistic regression is pretty complicated, the only way to use the same model for power calculation is to do an extensive simulation study that may take days. And the answer was, then do it. Yeah. And then the reviewer also said, well, PCORI doesn't ask me to comment on your analysis plan. They only asked for the study design and power. But I don't like your model. Your model is too complicated. I mean, kind of true. It is complicated. But we thought that we had a very good reason to go for this complicated model, because opioid prescription rate will go downhill anyways. So we had to do the simulation study with two goals. So first, I wanted to show that even if there is an interaction going on, I wanted to show that we have enough power with 2x2 design. Another thing I wanted to show is that our plan, our analysis plan and 2x2 design is somehow better than their 3-arm design using much simpler model. And there was a hidden goal for me as a statistician. I wanted to do this simulation study so perfectly so that they just can't question the validity of this simulation study. You know, if this doesn't get funded, it can't be my fault, you know? It can't be because of the crappy statistics. Okay, so simulation study is something that you do when you don't have a closed form solution for your power calculation. Basically, it is that you assume some reality, and then using computer, you generate the data, very probable data, that you may observe in reality, right? So we have to assume some reality, which we don't know for sure, right? So I just considered 12 different realistic scenarios varying all these things. So, because we don't know how big the interaction effect will be, so I used 2 different values. And also, we don't know how fast the opioid prescription rate will decrease, so I used different values for that as well. And also, I assumed different random effects for clinics. So it's how much patients will be clustered within each clinic. Right, and also we don't know the effect size of our intervention either. So I just used clinically meaningful difference provided by Kevin. So for these 12 scenarios, for each of the scenarios, I simulated 1,000 sets of data, and within each data, I simulated the outcomes for 18,000 patients. The reason this sample size is bigger than about 10,000 is that for this analysis, we are going to go backwards. So we are going to use some patients that already visited the site before the intervention actually starts using EHR data. Okay, so after you generate this 1,000 sets of data set, for each data set, I fit this piecewise logistic regression model that I was gonna fit in the trial. And then basically, I counted the number of data sets that gave me the significant p-value for that intervention effect and divided by 1,000. That's basically the power, right? So how likely are you going to detect the significant effect when there is a significant effect, right? So this calculation ran for 2 weeks on our stat server. And this is the result. So for 12 different scenarios, we got almost 100% power, even if there is an interaction. Right? And I also calculated power for the simpler model and from the 3-arm design that the reviewer suggested. That was also pretty high, but our power was a little higher.
Higher power.
Yeah. So basically, both models have very good power, but with our piecewise logistic model, we can say something about how fast it's declining. And on top of that, how we can accelerate, how much we can accelerate it, that change. So that was our argument. We both have enough power, but we, our model will provide more information. So to report this, I drafted 9-page, very, very detailed report so that I don't give them any chance to say that, well, this was not clear, well, this was not described in detail, something like this. So I just explained everything, and especially this model was very, very complicated. So I explained every single thing in the model and justified every choice of my parameters using, you know, other papers. And I also included my R code just in case they, if they don't still believe it, you know, they can run it by themselves for 2 weeks. Okay? So, I mean, they had to agree that we have enough power. So when we had the conference call with them, the reviewer was on the call as well. And I felt like her tone was much softer than on the paper, you know? She didn't really say, you're wrong or you have to change it. Instead, she said, well, your model is not incorrect. It is not wrong. 2x2 design is not wrong. It's okay, but I still prefer this. Like, so it was a little subtle change in the tone. But still, they so agreed that our design and analysis plan is good. And our model will give us a little more information about the outcomes. But still, this reviewer preferred her way. So what they suggested was do your piecewise logistic regression, but do it as a secondary analysis. As a primary analysis, she still preferred simpler method, like chi-square test or logistic regression without time as a covariate. So we agreed to do it. I mean, basically, we are going to do it anyways. It's just wording, like which one is primary and which one is secondary analysis. So that's how it ended. And at the end of the conference call, they said they liked my report. It was very clear and detailed. Yeah. So that is it. Any questions?
So it seems sort of hypocritical for them to say we want you to just use the three groups, but we think there might be an interaction, because then you can't determine the interaction.
That's true. Yeah, that is true.
Okay, I just want to make sure it wasn't.
But actually our 2x2 design was not really able, it was not powered to detect the interaction as well. So in terms of detecting the interaction term, didn't make any difference, yeah.
But it's also, in my opinion, her argument's flawed argument, because to do a 2x2 design, it's actually not a statistical reason why you would do it in terms of no interaction, because every single 2x2 trial that you would do would always have to have a precursor to it, which involved 4 times as many people in order to say there's no interaction. And you would never do that. I would never do that, at least. But it's more of the scientific reason why these two interventions would not interact with each other. That's the reason why. And so this statistician, I feel like, was coming at it from a purely statistical point of view, which is, it's a flawed argument, but.
And related to that, I mean, I think the interaction is going to be very interesting, and it very well might go the other direction. I mean, I saw you modeled for, a multiplicative, but it probably will go the other direction.
Yeah, actually,
right?
That was the reviewer's concern.
When you have two different.
Well, if there is a negative interaction.
Interaction, so that, you know, if there's this value of, you know, treatment one, and then this value of treatment two.
Her concern. But to detect the interaction, it's just like even our sample size is huge, but even with our sample size, the power to detect the interaction was very small. So you need a really, really big trial.
I see. Okay.
Yeah.
One more question.
So they wanted you to deal with the time issue, the time trend or the trend. Did they have a suggestion for you other than your model in the chi-square that actually addressed that issue of the time trend?
No, not this particular statistical. So okay. Reviewer didn't have any, yeah. Thank you.
Well, thank you. Sorry.
Sure.